All right, so we are looking at question number 17, and it's asking us to find and simplify the difference quotient f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, where h cannot equal 0 for the given function. We are given the function f of x is equal to 3x squared plus 2x minus 1. So our first step to take with our difference quotient is finding what f of x plus h is. As we know with function notation, whatever is inside these parentheses is what we need to plug into our x. And since f of x is just f of x and we know what f of x is, we don't need to solve for that, just for f of x plus h. So let's go ahead and do that. So we know with x plus h, we have to insert that and plug it in into every x value in our original given function. So when we do that, you're gonna get 3 times x plus h squared plus 2 times x plus h minus 1. So looking at this, our first step to do is to FOIL out this. We need to square our x plus h parentheses set. When we do that, we're going to get x plus h times x plus h. We know that x times x, when we FOIL, first, outer, inner, last, x times x is x squared, x times h is xh, h times x is xh, and h times h is h squared. So let's go ahead and combine like terms. We know there's only one x squared, it's going to be x squared. There's two like terms of xh, so you're going to get 2xh, and there's only one h squared, so it's going to be h squared. Now we know what to plug in for our term in the first spot for our x value. So let's go ahead and plug that in. When we do that, you're going to get 3 times x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. So let's go ahead and distribute out this 2 to our parentheses set. So when we do that, it's going to be 2 times x, which is plus 2x times 2h plus 2h. And since there's nothing to multiply onto our negative 1, that comes down. So let's distribute out this 3 to our parentheses set. So you're going to multiply to every term in the set. When you do that, you'll get 3x squared plus 3 times 2 is 6xh plus 3h squared, plus 2x, plus 2h, and minus 1. Now we know that f of x plus h is equal to this. So now we know that we have to plug this section, this big old part right here, into our difference quotient so that we are able to find it. So let's go ahead and plug f of x plus h into our formula to find the difference quotient. So when you do that, you're going to get 3x squared plus 6xh plus 3h squared plus 2x plus 2h minus 1. And you're going to subtract your entire first original f of x given function, because the subtraction sign is subtracting the entire function, not just the first term. So let's go ahead and put that in parentheses. 3x squared plus 2x minus 1. All divided by h. So now let's go ahead and distribute out this minus sign. And since there's nothing else to be done to this chunk right here, we're going to leave it alone and just write it in the numerator right here. We know that a negative 1 times 3x squared will get us negative 3x squared. Negative times positive 2x will get you negative 2x. And a negative 1 times a negative 1 gets you positive 1. Remember, this is all divided by h. So now that we have that, let's go ahead and cancel all of our like terms. We see that we have a positive 3x squared. Let's go find something like it. And look at that, you have a negative 3x squared, so those cancel out. So moving on to 6xh, we can see that there's no other like term. 3h squared, no other like term. 2x, would you look at that? There's another like term. 2h, there's no other like term, but negative 1 has a like term. So once we cancel all of those out, we know that we are going to be left with the function 3h squared plus 6xh plus 2h. And that is going to be divided by h. So let's find out any other like terms. So we see we have a like term in our numerator. That means we can go ahead and factor it out so we can cancel it out. So we see that our like term is h. So once we factor that out, We're going to get h with 3h plus 6x plus 2 divided by h. And once we have that h term by itself, we can go ahead and cancel it out in both the numerator and the denominator. So once we do that, we are going to be left with the term, the difference quotient, 3h plus 6x plus 2. And as you can see, there's nothing else to be done. There's nothing left to cancel out, combine. That is it. That is your difference quotient. As always, comment below if you have any questions or concerns. Thanks for watching.